today. We're going to talk about FSMA receiver liability for supplier preventive controls. If you look at this first slide, you can see my name, Dr. John Ryan. Also, you can see my website, ryansystems.com, my email address, jryan@ryansystems.com, and my cell phone number. So after the session, if you have any questions or you want more information, go ahead and send them to me, and I'll be happy to talk to you about them. Well, let's take a look at a few items that answer the question, how is your supplier food safety system doing? You know, everybody's got to do hazard analysis and valid preventive controls. Now, these things you have to do, your supplier has to do them. You have to determine risk levels and processes, procedures, etc. Most companies have temperature controls, sanitation requirements, documentation, food safety certification. Compliance records come into play here, and so does the supplier food safety history, as well as environmental sampling and tests. All these types of things sometimes come together to make an overall food safety system for you and your suppliers. So, what is this subpart G requirements to establish and implement a supply chain program? That's what we're going to work on today. We're going to talk about liability, yours and theirs, responsibilities of the receiving facility, that's you, the fact that you have to have only approved suppliers, and you have to conduct supplier verification activities for raw materials and other ingredients, and that includes on-site audits, as well as everybody has to fulfill the requirements. So if you open your refrigerator and look at the food inside, on the average, your food has traveled 2,000 miles in the U.S. to get into that refrigerator. That's part of the reason for the new FSMA Act and our new requirements, that complexity. And what this creates now is this liability of everyone in the supply chain called vicarious liability. So this situation demands that your company is responsible for your suppliers, their ability to deliver temperature-controlled, safe, sanitary food. So we've got three primary factors that cause food suppliers to adopt food safety, traceability, recall, etc. One of them is the market. The market's always telling us what to do. We have to respond to it. We got this new standard, ISO 22000. If you don't know what that is, look it up. Buy yourself a copy. It's International Food Safety Standards, okay? Put on by the International Standards Organization. It's a worldwide organization that's come together to do that. They also have 22005, which is traceability. Cost you $75 for each set of standards, and start working your way in that direction. Second issue, product liability, I mentioned a minute ago. And then, of course, FSMA and all the other food safety laws and regulations that we have. So between the market, product liability, and the legal part, things are changing, and they're changing quick. Remember Chipotle? Okay, so Chipotle's sitting out there, had many problems over the last couple of years, never has found the cause of its problems, which I suspect has to do more with its spices than anything. Spices carry a lot of bacteria, a lot of problems come in on them. A lot of people they throw the spices on their food without cooking it, so you have an opportunity for all kinds of problems in different places. But Chipotle stock is in the tank because they didn't control their suppliers. That's the bottom line on it. And remember, they had no food safety system at all anyway. Here's another one. These Colorado farmers, in 2013, killed 33 people. Cantaloupe, right? Listeria. They faced up to 6 years in prison, $1.5 million. They went bankrupt. And this is how the feds, got together to catch them, even though the FDA had no laws against this that they could charge them with. This company shipped contaminated food using interstate commerce, okay? And what got them was the transportation sector and the federal government. So, and the reason this slide in here is to explain to you that the FDA doesn't work alone. It works with a lot of other agencies that can all gang up when they choose to. So what does the FDA expect? They want you and your suppliers to establish a risk-based preventive approach. So we want to prevent the problems that are risky, okay? For all foods consumed in the U.S., whether imported